had a really good day off of scrims. Pull day.
Off of scrims?
Off of scrims, yeah.
Didn't you guys start scrims when Bunny got back?
We did, but we had some problems. And today we couldn't get scrims, so we've been off-ish. But
off-ish.
Yeah, the grind doesn't stop. We're still doing the ranked grind.
Yeah, they were doing ranked as soon as I walked in.
Yeah.
And Bunny was ringing for PML team.
He is loud. I cannot stream with Bunny ringing. He does not know how loud he is when he talks.
He'd give up the drafts too.
Mm-hmm.
Like
mm-hmm.
he's just screaming
he's,
them, you know.
He's leaking.
Just like another team we know might be leaking scrims from a certain PML team. We could talk about that. Actually, you know what? I don't have a topic lined up for that, so I'm not going to get up and change it. But what do you think about that whole thing? That whole fiasco.
Hello.
Hey.
I don't know. Ask Payne. Payne, come here.
What do you think about that?
We're talking about
leaks.
You want to
come
now.
Sit down in the hero seat? We're talking about leaks.
Oh, shoot.
Come here. Pop a squat.
Pop in a squat.
It's Payne. I want to put your Twitter on here. Don't kick Powtech's computer that we're totally not using for a mic stand. Do you want your name up?
No, I'm good.
You sure? Okay. RNG Hero? You want that instead?
Yeah,
perfect. Okay. What do you think about that whole fiasco? The scrim leaking that Flashpoint did? Well, actually, we should probably give people some backing because like not everyone probably knows what's going on, right?
Mm-hmm.
So Team Flashpoint, it was Flashpoint, right? Crossbow
right.
Logic,
yeah.
Those
yes.
guys? Team Flashpoint was scrimming against Bork from the PML, and there was kind of a... Spawn camping Victor that got three different kills on like three 1v1 forcing players, and it was pretty funny, but... It was in a scrim, and it got posted to Twitter.
Right.
They asked them to take it down. They said they would, and then they never did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, I don't know. What are you guys' thoughts on that? That whole situation.
Personally, when I first saw it, I thought it was hilarious. I'm not gonna lie, but thinking about it and like putting my shoes in them or
shoes in anybody.
putting my feet in their shoes.
That's actually honestly, if you can just do it, bro, that would get you so much cash on the internet.
Putting my feet in their shoes, I think I'd be pretty pissed like they were. I'd politely ask them to take it down. If they didn't, then I'd just blacklist them. But
no fear.
But seeing what they did, I don't know. I don't think it's right, but...
It's the console norm, though.
Yeah,
it is
the console
norm.
It's the console norm,
but like,
if they're stepping into the PC arena...
Yeah.
They have to understand the PC rules,
yeah.
too.
Right.
It is the console norm, but it's also like the... being a good person norm to do
right.
something like that if someone asks.
Mm.
Like, even just say, yo, can you upload it in, like, 2 weeks? Like, it'll still get Twitter clicks, bro. If you do
yeah.
it after MSI,
yeah.
it'll still get Twitter clicks. Like,
but
or relegations. Relegations. It'll be
but
next week.
It was funny, though, right?
It was pretty fucking funny. It was pretty funny. I can't say that it wasn't. Are people coming in spamming this bike to help Mike? I really shouldn't have named the title that. That's probably going to be half the chat. This entire episode. We can actually, yeah, it's good that I have you here, because we could talk about your opinions on this, because I like getting a multitude. My
sure.
first topic for today was, is Damage Amp the new, you gotta pick characters that have it, like the new built-in CCR, built-in caught? What are your thoughts on the whole overarching, like, every good character has a Damage Amp, you want one on your team or else you're kind of falling behind unless you draft, like, a crazy sustained composition?
Yeah. I mean, I think, like, if the enemy team pick... You don't want the enemy team to
change,
have a...
If you're going to stay here, I'm going to change your name. What's your Twitter?
Go ahead.
if Payne2K?
Payne2K.
Underscore,
right?
Right.
No underscore. Just Payne2K.
Oh, just Payne2K. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to change it if you're actually going to be here, because now I see what you mean. Okay.
Welcome
you
back.
You can continue, though, while I do this.
But yeah, if the enemy team has, like, a Genos, and you let him have the Tyra, then that's kind of, like, hurting yourself, because they have double damage amp.
Yeah.
So I feel like if one team just like first picks the Genos plus say like I don't know like a Barrack or Ashe or something, then to keep up with their damage and you pretty much just have to get another damage champ like Tyra or something. But
Fury up with the ultimate
Fury,
stuff.
Right, exactly. So I guess it is just like the new CCR as it says, but yeah.
I don't think it's the new CCR. I think control comp still can work. You obviously need to get a big beefy boy tank like an Atlas or like a Khan, somebody that can actually make plays.
Yeah.
Is it really strong? Yeah, absolutely. But I mean, you guys scrim, we scrim. You know, we've beaten comps, we've taken games off comps with you know heavy amounts of
yeah.
of damage amp. Just playing the right control comp.
Would you say it's defining the meta right now?
It's definitely defining
the meta. It makes it look like I'm reading off notes. Yeah, this is just chat, I promise.
It's definitely defining the meta. Like, you see how early Tyra is getting picked. We saw Tyra bans, I believe, last week.
All this week. Yeah. Kanga banned it, like, four times.
Yeah. They banned it. It's definitely defining the meta, but it's, you know, it's too early to say, is this just, like, a hype train thing or what? Mm-hmm. Because you look at Tyra's base kit, it's garbage. You look at Genos's base kit, it's not that good. It's okay. Being able to heal through walls, whatever, you know, that's good. But
the ultimate is very good when combo.
All these characters, besides Fury has an awesome base kit. All these characters that have these damage amps all have really trash base kits. So, it's definitely meta defining. Mm-hmm. And it's something you have to play around. So.
What level of damage boost do you guys think is, like, actually, I guess I can give my opinion, too. I think it is meta-defining right now. I think, like, you really do want it in your kit because it just makes your champs better. Like, if you get a good draft and then you get a Tyra or a Genos, your draft is just better.
Mm.
You know, because if your Bomb King is doing 1K damage, 12K damage, 12K. 1K to 1.2K.
Wow.
Holy. See you later, Terminus.
We saw that bug, right? That one bug? it just makes your drafts better. So until something happens to it, I think it is going to be, like, the new standard for drafts and stuff. The other thing I was going to say was, what do you guys think, me and Kyle, we talked about this right before we started, but, like, what form of damage amp, if it were to stay in, would be acceptable? So, like, is only the Furia damage amp okay because it's on an ultimate? Is Tyra's not okay because it's on an ability, but Genosis is okay because it's on a support? Like, what do you think the line is where, like, damage amping should be in or not?
I think Tyra's is pretty ridiculous, especially with the card where you get, like, all your cooldowns.
Oh, yeah, the Primal Might, yeah.
Yeah, so all your cooldowns reduced if you get, like, in a limb. I think it's kind of ridiculous, especially when you could put it on two people with Hunting Party, or...
Hunting Party.
So, I don't...
I'm going to turn this, by the way, because this was set up for, like, last time, and now, there we go.
Revealed... And taking 25% increased damage is a double whammy, dude.
It's pretty ridiculous.
It's rough.
I think Genosis is fine, and I think Furious is fine, especially since it's an ultimate. I just think Tyra is just ridiculous.
What do you think, Gus?
I'm half with him, but I think the Genos part is a little ridiculous, too. I like it being on the Fury ult. I think that's fine.
Mm-hmm. We could mention Torvald, too. I didn't even mention Torv, but... Torv,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, we can talk about Torv, too. Torv is... I would love to... I'm okay with Field Study, but his base kit is just garbage. He's a walking shielder, right?
Yeah.
That's all he does. All he does is says, you have a 2,000 shield, you have 30% damage, please carry me. I can't do anything for you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
His DPS is garbage. His mobility is garbage. The character is garbage. He's a shield buff. I'm okay with Field Studying having damage amp until they completely rework that character. Genos, no. But then again, the only reason you do pick Genos is for
because
Luminary.
Of the damage amp. I mean, you would have to have something. You would have to rework Luminary into something that is, like, actually playable.
Yeah.
I know one of the legendaries that was actually in the game's code was... shots from your start, shots from the primary reduce the cooldown of Astral Mark by like 0.1 second or like 0.2 seconds per shot hit. Mm. So, I mean, something like that. Do you think that would be enough to keep Genos
in?
Oh, come on in, buddy. Here's, oh, sorry. Oh, very fun. Do you think that would be enough to.
Take your seat, bunny.
Yeah, that's your seat, buddy.
Oh.
Just don't knock anything over. Do you want to stand?
I'll stand until we're done with this topic.
Okay.
I'm going to bounce.
Okay, sure. Man legs his back, says Tolos. Do you think that would be enough to keep Genos in the meta? Like, if he had that legendary where he could just spam marks across his team if he's doing damage?
I mean, we talked about this before the stream, too.
Yeah.
I think, like you said, it would just make him a safer Grover, right? He would be able to have 3, 4, 5 people marked at the same time, even with a lower Kronos. His healing's still really not there. You still pick him for damage amp, right? So...
Someone mentioned move speed instead of damage amp. Do you think that would be maybe something? Make Luminary do like a Nimble 2? Or a Nimble 1.5?
Wouldn't that just be like a weaker Maldamba? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think the situations where you take Maldamba right now are your team's low on CC, and you have characters that can really utilize the movement speed.
Yeah.
Right? So that's sort of his niche. I think Genos would need a niche, honestly. And I think healing through walls is his niche, right? So what could Hyrez do to... make that niche better. And that's something to think about. I like the old code line of the shots reducing the heal cooldown. That could be cool.
Yeah.
Five targets heal, or four targets being healed at the same time. Could be good.
But, maybe, maybe I honestly think they could go back and put his zero cooldown Stellar Wind back. I think he could use that again.
Yeah,
I feel like that'd be so annoying. Oh.
I really think the only reason that was strong was level 10 cards.
Yeah, and
binary,
it was the bug with
binary
star.
For like
it was because
damage.
You could auto cancel the binary star. I'm doing this because
yeah.
That's how what I have my Stellar Wind on my thumb. But like, you could auto cancel Stellar. I think he could take that back. Like if they remove Luminary, he's going to need a lot. He's going to need
he's going to need
that back. He's going to need some legendary that makes his healing actually viable. He's going to need something.
What I'm worried about, I don't want them, if they ever did decide, like, hey, you know what, you know, the pros are right, the high-level players are right, damage amp is a little bit of a problem, I don't want them to Fernando him. You know what I mean?
Completely
like,
destroy
when they got rid of Cauterizing Kit, they got rid of his movement speed, they got rid of the damage on his fireball, like,
yeah.
They gutted him. I don't want them to gut the character. They need to, if they change that, they need to
buff
it
in some other way.
Yeah.
I mean, I think with the AOC and everything, I think they've been very, very receptive to feedback. I think most of their changes since then have been very good.
Yeah.
I can't really think of anything that's been, like, super degenerate. So I trust that if they remove Legendary, they could do something. Ooh, giving Creed jump. Oh, my God. What if he got the jumpy general stuff in base kit instead?
That'd be so troll.
Oh.
It's hard to fit that into a deck, right? Because, like,
you need your
cooldown. You want healing radius.
You want range.
He has so many. There's so many characters with fun cards, man. Like Maldamba's win rate right now in ranked, and I know I'm going on a tandem.
No, it's fine.
Maldamba's win rate is like 44%.
Yeah.
People, I'm guessing, aren't putting Eerie Presence in their deck. Put it in the base kit. Damba has so many freaking fun cards that you can't use because you have to have
four,
at least Eerie
Presence
3 or 4.
I want to see Liminal Passage 5 in some decks, bro.
Yes.
I want to see Damba slithering to space. I think Garrow was running 2 during one of the matches,
oh,
right?
Really?
I think Garrow was running Liminal Passage.
I didn't see his decks.
Yeah, it was, I think so. It was like a temporary build. It's one of his builds.
Mm-hmm.
But I found that interesting. I like Liminal Passage, bro. I think it's a pretty okay card. I think it's kind of underused. People run like, what do people run instead? Like that?
I run heavy DR, heavy movement.
Well, like,
speed
yeah, no, of course, of course.
Yeah.
I'm saying like as a one of. I'm not
the
saying.
The filler
mm-hmm.
cards, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my filler card? I just do dash cooldown.
Okay, like
a
half second? And
I do half second off Gord, half second off a dash.
Okay. I do half second off Gord
mm-hmm.
and 10% longer dash.
Yeah.
Because I'm getting Chronos anyway. I mean, I'm getting that cooldown. See, T-Mac knew.
What?
T-Mac, he said CD Slither before you did.
Yeah.
He knew. Ooh, Astral Mark give lifesteal. That would be interesting.
That'd be interesting mechanic.
But
that'd
it would
be
scale
so
badly.
Snowball-y.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it'd
be really
it
snowball-y.
Would scale kind of badly. But there's some champs that could really use that. So I'm like, any champ with, like, oh my god.
Toga?
Oh,
with
Toga.
Toga, dude?
Bro, oh my god. Imagine 50% that on
trigger happy?
Imagine that on
Pip. Oh my god.
Moxie. Oh,
Moxie.
Oh, that would be really interesting, though.
Yeah.
Reduce Hunter's Mark from 2 marks to 1. Yeah, I think they just need to maybe make Hunting Party just 50, like, they need to just make Hunting Party 2 charges and give it something else. Don't give it the team damage boost. The single damage boost, I think, is fine.
Yeah, it's just really annoying to play against damage boost,
mm-hmm.
especially as tanks, with it being picked basically every single game. There's going to be some type of damage boosting on one team. You can't even like ban out everything, right? Corvalt's not being seen at all because his shit is busted as fuck.
Yeah.
And he's boring to play, and he's like boring to watch too. Tyra's fucking insane right now, being picked really early or banned. Janos was the fucking meta for the last 3 months,
yeah.
right? And just fell off a little bit this last week and a half, 2 weeks.
Because Furia became more playable.
Furia was
people.
Playable now. There's Grover back, which makes it so you could play, like, clumpy comps, right? So, like, go against that. And what's the last damage boost? There's one more, right?
There's Torv, Janos, Furia.
I think Furia ult is completely fine. I agree with you guys. Like,
yeah.
For it to be an alt kit, I think it's good. It, like, allows aggression, right? And
yeah.
there's like
I think
you're there's a few
too.
Of it.
Yeah.
yeah. Everything else, the other three, I just don't like it. I think other mechanics could be
like,
in place
here's,
of that.
Here's
or
the real argument for why damage boost I think is kind of negative to the scene is like, what is the counterplay to someone having Luminary? Just their Genos decided that he will do more damage now. This Tyra has looked at me. Like with Fury ult, there's the show them no mercy. Like you have so much time to prepare
mm-hmm.
for that. And, like, Torv, there's, like, the Wrecker counterplay, but, like, whether you get caught against a Genos, it's not going to make him do any more damage. Like, yes, you can get the Havens, but it's still, like, regardless, you're still taking more damage. Your credits are still being thrown away.
Yeah, and the problem is it changes matchups completely, right? Like the Eevee and the Maeve matchup is a really fun matchup to watch, but as soon as you give one of them a Luminary Pocket, they have huge distinct advantage over the other, right?
Especially if that 15% pushes them over a breakpoint.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to two-shot somebody instead of three, whatever. Yeah,
exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if they can, the breakpoints, the damage boost pushes you over, like, that two-shot breakpoint. I saw, I forget what it was. I think there was, like, a triple damage boost stack or something. And I'm pretty sure Maeve was doing, like, 700 damage a dagger.
725, I think.
It's, like, 725 when it's all stacked. That's absurd.
Mm-hmm.
That is absurd. Like, 1450 per Maeve shot. That's with, like, all the damage boost stacked up, and like that's not even like a weird comp. That's like with all meta champions.
With meta champions,
yeah. That's crazy. But yeah, I don't know. I think damage boost is a little degenerate. I think we all agree. I'm sure something will be done with everyone talking to the AOC. But I have a feeling it probably won't happen for a little bit, because I'm sure the decisions for this patch were made, like, a month ahead of time before the whole Tyrant Genos Furia thing really started picking up. So I have a feeling if something was going to be done, it would probably be done September.
Yeah.
Right? Because the patches are every 2 months now.
Mm.
Unless maybe they'll do, like, a balance in the middle, but I don't think they're going to. So we have a... Settle in. We're going to have to settle
in. Thank you, Cus.
Ride the Tyra.
Ride the Tyra band wave.
Yeah.
Probably. I don't think this meta is that. Other than that, I don't think this meta is that bad. Honestly,
I think it's
good. Like,
there's
degenerate stuff. It's a flexible meta.
I think hitscans are still a little bit in a rough spot, right? They've been for a while now. I think, like, most of the season.
Like, strong? You mean, like, they're strong? The
like, they're not strong enough, I think.
You don't think Tyra, Vivian, and
Leon those are like
enough?
Boring hitscans. I'm talking about Andro, Talos.
You think Talos is more fun than Leon?
Then
Vivian's fun.
Vivian is not fun to watch.
I think Vivian's actually a lot of fun to watch. To
what?
Be honest.
Yeah.
Nice.
It's not fun to play against, but it's fun to watch.
Yeah. Okay.
Just like, because when they pop
seeing,
off.
Seeing
Mudu
just big dick against the Ruckus and just sit there
yeah,
and fire.
Yeah.
Like, that is actually cool
that.
To watch.
That tilts me, though, dude. It's usually, because, like, those are, like, fuck tank characters, right? The Tyra, the Vivian, which are, like, the two best EDs right now, right?
Tyra
maybe Cassie, but, like, Cassie's half projectile, half...
I think they have more counterplay than other champions in terms of, like, the damage spot. Like, Tyra Vivian, I think you can just draft, like, really aggressive into them and make something happen. Of course, it depends on how much of a control comp the team has around them, right? If they have a strong...
Like, BV tank.
Yeah. If they have a strong BV tank that will be in the way, it's going to be a lot harder. But there are ways to draft into them, I think. It's not, like, uncounterable.
They're uncounter. Oh, yeah.
It's not like Masters Land BK shit.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, no.
I'm sorry if that brought up any bad memories.
No, you know what I'd love to talk about? Probably not this week on a different episode. I would love to actually talk about, like, built-in character kit designs. Like how I talked about Eerie Presence before.
Yeah.
Like, other characters that have cards that are, like, necessary.
That, yeah, like...
That I would love to see just put on base kit.
Like, Bowling Ball and Beric, or... what else? I mean, like, everyone needs cooldown, right?
I'm saying, like, necessary. Like, I think Eerie Presence is necessary. Like,
I think
are
so.
Are there any other characters that have necessary cards?
Built-ins? Let's see. Can chat hit us up? What are there any necessary built-ins on characters?
And not just, like, oh, you need movement speed on this character because you've got to go the fast.
What
about
like,
Terminus? Do you feel like
Necromantic Might?
Yeah,
think
do you feel
necessary?
Like that's necessary?
On a Decimation build, yeah. But like you can build without worrying about your charges.
Yeah.
Like you can build. I don't think it's necessary. I think let's see, Grok, Totem CD, tons of support ones.
Support's the main one. It's not really for any like.
Well, no, I just had one in my head. Reset on Andro. If you don't have dash reset on Andro, your build is like.
You're real tough.
Like,
I agree with that.
You're really limited. Yeah. Even if it's just like an 80% reduction. Blossom Range on Grover. Yeah.
Yeah.
I would say that's a necessary card. Yeah.
I mean, like, Term is bad without it right now, but, like, in the past, like, I don't know. You can play, like, when Undying was good, you didn't need it. Like, you could have just played, like, Health, Rejuve. Like, you could have played other stuff.
Yeah, Health, Rejuve. Yeah.
Just be a big dumb rock.
DR and all that dumb shit.
That's is it really just support characters that kind of have those cards then, or?
I think it's mainly support, right?
Eevee Blink Heal. You can play without it though. That's
really?
That's only because of Wormhole, dude. Like, what do you think would happen to Eevee if they removed the ability to get Blink procs on Wormhole?
Summon 5 and R. Okay, bud.
What do you mean Blink? Like flicker?
You know how when you blink black?
Yeah,
like it doesn't proc for your Wormhole.
Yeah.
When you blink back, if she didn't get that extra 375.
Three crits off.
It would make her a lot worse, and I don't think that'd be unfair. Focusing lens. Vivian move speed is actually essential. I agree, but I think that'd be degenerate if you could get that speed and that lifesteal on Ash.
So I guess it's not that big of a deal. I'm just a Damba baby, dude.
Damba baby.
I'm just a Damba baby, chat.
I think there's definitely some they could build in.
Yeah. If you actually like physically look down and look at it and see like what cards are being ran all the time.
All right, if anybody, I don't know if we have any other topics on that. So we can talk about this later in the Q&A, but for now, we can go to the next thing, which is just this week of PPL.
Bang, bang.
You guys saw all the games, right?
Yeah.
Most of them, at least?
Most of them.
Bro, that first set was crazy.
Oh, yeah.
That first set was great.
Yeah, that was something. That was probably the best set of Paladins the last year. Right?
I mean, it was the longest.
It was
statistically.
Long.
I mean, there's no other 8-game sets in Paladins history.
But it definitely, it had, like, everything, right? It was back and forth. It had two different, like, styles of the game being played, right? Where,
and they were both working at different times.
Yeah, they were both working on different maps and different situations, giving some things and substituting some things out. We saw the double off tank being really good for Nip, and for VP,
double
we saw the Janos with double main tank.
Yeah.
A lot of Drogo's play with the Janos whenever they had it, basically, right? He played it, got banned out on Bazaar, I think. He played it on Stone. He
played
it's
insane
on Ascension.
Bizarre.
Yes. It is very, very annoying on that map.
And they would have even won. They could have won that map.
Yeah.
That map was absolutely winnable. They just had a poor zone. Diggy snuck by.
Diggy on map.
Here was my thought process there, right? Like, I'm trying to cast what's going on. I'm like, they need to focus down the Ash because I'm thinking she's the only one who can touch with ult. And I like scan who's left on the, and I just see four people. And I'm like, no way. There's no way. There's no way she got by. Who paused that game? I don't remember. That's a bug. They already have a, let's see. They should already have a protocol in case the game crashes. They do. It's what happened. And it wasn't like a regular crash. It was
that was the first time I've heard of that crash.
It happened to us in scrims.
Really?
It's funny. It actually happened to us twice. No, once in scrims. And it's funny because like my spreadsheet is all like, you know, win loss whatever. And then like randomly it's like draw 3-3 because what else do I put?
Yeah. So like how long ago did it start happening? Because it never happened to us. In scrims.
This patch, I think.
This patch.
Well, it would be this patch, but like, how long ago during this patch? Because there was a few hotfixes that happened mid patch, right?
Recently.
Yeah, there was a few hotfixes, so maybe it was one of those.
Maybe. I know. The last time we had something like this happen was the team that it should happen. It was Anima. It was 3-3, so it can't be a draw. If one equals to last one to cap or push.
No,
I don't agree with that either.
Because the last mid-fight is going to be completely different than the other ones.
That last mid-fight, I think it could have gone VP's way, easily.
It could have gone either way.
And I think that just because it was no ults on either side, I think someone was at like 92, but like it was everyone used all the ults on the defense, and it was against a Torg, right? So like a team with no ults against, it was basically a first mid-fight with Wrecker 3 and Caught 3.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think that goes for the team against the Torg, personally.
Usually, but like you never know in Paladins, like legit anything can happen in that mid. You know, someone could dash through mines and no one notice it and get flanked. Like there could be so many different things that go on during that mid fight, so like there's really no way to like safely call who's going to win that mid.
Yeah.
I think even if one team has 5 ults and the other team has 0, you can't say the team with 5 ults automatically wins the game. Like
yeah,
because
you can counterplay it. Yeah,
you can counterplay it. And
like Inara, like they had Inara on that game. It was Inara Barrack, right?
Yeah.
That was VP's comp.
Yeah,
and like Inara can DR the pit bolt now. Like there's
they can wall their team off. Like there's so many different things that can happen. You can't call anything.
I think VP were going into that last mid with an advantage though.
Mm-hmm.
Personally.
I do think there should be a is the right word mechanic? Not really mechanic, but there should be a way for them to go
save the game state
and go back to it. From starting from each mid, I think.
I mean, I think That'd be nice, but I don't know how soon that would be a thing. Like, they already slowed down the patch cycle to avoid bugs, and, like, I feel like that's not really high on their priority list. I mean, maybe, is there a way to just force a, like, it might take a hot minute, but, like, I mean, the casters can fill time. I mean, I was able to do it. The casters can fill time. Like, if there's a way to just, like, remake it with, like, GM commands, we had, like, the footage is being recorded, right? Like, couldn't you just be, like, GM force alt or something? Like,
right.
I know there is a force alt. I just don't know if there's, like, a force
credit.
I don't know if there's like a specifically like give me 86%
ultimate. Yeah, I think a big thing is credits, right? Because credits were huge at that time, right? Everyone needs the right amount of credits, the right amount of items.
But when the game crashes, the spectator doesn't crash immediately. The spectator still has those 90 seconds. So that's time for the spec to pause, get all that information, and then relay it.
Yeah, I feel like that could have been a thing, but it would have been annoying.
What they did was the best thing they could do with what they had. Mm-hmm. I don't think anyone was like, people were frustrated about the remake, but like, I don't think anyone thought that Hi-Rez made the wrong decision, because they didn't. I don't think they
did. No, they didn't. I mean, what else can they do, right?
There's nothing
really
they can
option.
Do
right.
Yeah,
you can't call the last mid, right? You can't say either team's going to win it, right? So the only thing to do is to reset it. Maybe the only other thing I can imagine them doing is just saying avoid the whole map, pick a new map,
maybe, and redo the draft. I think they should have redone draft. I think they should have redone draft. That was the mistake, but I think the teams agreed to keep the draft. I don't think that was, like, that was the admin's decision. I think the teams agreed to redo same draft.
I could see a redraft happening, yeah.
Redraft would have been the best way to start from ground zero, because, obviously, Nip learned so much.
Mm-hmm.
They learned so much from that game. They played the mid completely. Like, I mentioned it on the cast, like, they had, like, crazy counterplay that one mid where, like, they... VP had this good, cool counter shot where was waiting, like, hiding to the right of the barn door, so that if Alex tried to dive in, he was going to wall the choke and isolate the rest of his team. But they just waited. Like, they were, like, so many levels. It was, like, the sixth mid. Of course they're going to have each other figured out by that point, you know?
Right.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I think it should have been... I don't think the map had to be different, but I think the draft could have been different. I think that would have been the one fixing point.
Mm-hmm.
I will say, though, I had no idea what was going on. All I know is I was talking to Rain Day, and then, like, someone just walked by. Like, Poulet walks by outside of the caster room, and I was like,
huh.
I'm like, oh, God. I'm thinking, like, how long do I have to fill right now?
That's
like, what am I going to have to BS right now to keep this interesting? But no, that set was fantastic. I'm really happy I got to cast it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Honestly.
I meant to mention to you that your casting was really good. That
thank
set.
You. Yeah, thank you, man. It was actually good. Really bad game one. That happens a lot.
I only got to see like the last half
good.
Of that game. Or last half.
Good. That was the only time I was actually
you're
casting.
You're not a fan of your casting? Why not?
What? No, I love casting. It's just...
Well, the first map,
my,
why
okay,
do you think you did bad?
Even Rain Day had to like tell me to slow down. I was like talking too fast. I was like... I don't know. I was a little nervous because it was my first time casting PPL.
Yeah,
you know? Like,
yeah. Mm-hmm. First time PPL.
I hadn't casted
it
since
set.
The last time. It was had potential to be a really good set. It was my first time casting PPL, so like that Ascension peak, don't watch it.
Okay.
But the rest of the set, I think, was good.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. I think it picked up a lot as time went on.
Yeah, I was definitely a fan of the casting.
Yeah, thank you. It was really, really fun. I loved doing it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if they ever, I'm actually going to be back on next Friday.
Oh,
yeah. Because
what's
that? I don't know. We actually get the schedules like the day of.
Oh.
I knew I wasn't casting today at 12:30 today. that's when Nick sent out the schedules. I was just like, I was in the green room and just like, looks like I'm only on desk today.
Nice.
But it makes sense. I mean, they have people that, like, they had Tom and Evan and everybody there.
Yeah. And certain days people might be sick or something, so they don't want to set something up too early.
Yeah. It makes sense. They do it once the talent is there to make the schedules.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But next Friday, I'll be doing the whatever games are that day. And at MSI, I will probably do whatever I can if they want me. Like, I mean, it depends on, like... I mean, if my team makes it to the finals, then, like...
You can't get
cast. I won't cast, yeah. And I'm sure I won't be casting them. I'm sure the finals are going to be Evan and Pretty Hair.
Yeah.
Right.
Like, I'm sure there's no
that's
other people
that's
going to
be
the
casting
cast
the for it.
Yeah.
Desk you might be on.
Yeah, maybe. I'll have to see. I'll talk to them about it.
Mm-hmm.
I had a lot of fun, and the feedback was pretty good. So I think... is my chat... Has no one said anything, or is my chat just frozen? What was the last thing in your chat? Yeah, I agree. Okay, just make sure.
Yeah.
Thank you, Chash.
It's good.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, I thought it was broken. Chat was been really quiet since we started talking about this.
So after the first amazing set, we had...
We had the second amazing set.
Mike
the Lord... Mike the bike
Mike
riding
the
his
bike.
Way into that set. What a lore, dude.
Dude, I was so hyped up for that first map. 2-0, yeah. Shattered Desert. Yeah. We're like, what the fuck?
Mike was killing it, bro. I think he had like the most kills on the team after those 2-0.
Yeah, he did. He did.
He was actually killing
everyone. Dies only one time. They push it in, and we're like, huh, this is actually going to be the actual set. Yeah.
Dude, on the last map in the green room, I was like, bro, imagine being like a pretty good CSGO player, getting assigned for an esports org, and then being like, hey, we need you to go play a Nara. Like, imagine like that's how you end up. Like, we need you to stand on point. Stop the mic, please. Dude, Mike is like the nicest guy.
Yeah.
Like, he's super, super nice. Yeah, I hung out with him in the coach room, like, when we were playing Navi. I talked to the other coaches, I mean.
Yeah.
I listen to my comms, but, you know, there's downtime. I always, like, I'll ask some questions and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And Mike's super, super nice. He didn't know the game at all that week. So, clearly he learned a lot.
Yeah.
He's ready for it.
Nice guy and ultra pro for your play. Dude, did you guys notice that, like, reaction he had to Lazy getting booped off the cart?
Yeah, I noticed
that. That was, like, long-term player reaction. Like, the second he got booped, he 180 flicked to dash in. Like, that was sick.
Yeah.
For a level 20 player, that'd be the highlight of his casuals. Like, for real. But yeah, I mean, Kanga kind of snuck away a win.
Yeah, and there's not much like Navi can do, right? Like, you're down a whole player in a professional match. Like, there's legit nothing you can do about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, Mike did the best he could do.
Yeah, you have to draft around, like, having players swapping roles, right? Because Fnatic was playing DPS.
Yeah.
And that's the best you can do. Of course, they're going to lose the set. It's unfortunate for them, but...
We were talking about this. We were saying, like, last week, even though if we 4-0'd...
SSG,
we still would have made it because Kanga would have had a free win.
Yeah. That's
true. So,
yeah, the only way that would have changed if we beat Kanga 2 weeks ago. That would be the only way for us. We'd have to beat Kanga, then beat SSG.
Then beat Renegades.
Well, beat Renegades and beat Envy, I think it is. And they
is
have
that
to
your
lose
last match?
To,
yeah.
Yeah, and they have to lose to VP next week. And I think that's what needed to happen for us to go to MSI.
Right.
Since they got the win versus Navi.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of shit needed to happen.
And, like, honestly, like, if VP had turned up today and beaten Navi, then people would have been like, okay. Like, you know, maybe Kanga could have taken it otherwise, but, like, the Navi that showed up today, bro.
They were
firing on all cylinders.
Point.
They really were. Also, I just want to say... I don't remember. Did I mention the Vivian during the... No, I didn't. Because I was like, I was thinking on the desk I would have mentioned the Vivian. But like, Ascension Peak Nips draft where they had the Cassie instead of the Vivian on Ascension. Mm. And then they lost to the Drogos. I really felt like Vivian would have turned that game for them. If they had picked the Vivian.
Mm-hmm.
If Nip had.
Yeah.
Into the Drogos and the On.
Yeah.
And then, because Navi did the same thing and absolutely...
Demolished.
Absolutely. I mean, like, they had trouble pushing. Both teams had trouble pushing. But like, Navi snuck away with the win.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So, I don't know. I felt a little vindicated, but then I remembered that I didn't say it yesterday because I was casting. I didn't want... I when you're casting, you can't, like,
mention
say your analysis in
the
start.
The draft,
yeah,
it makes sense.
You can in, like, certain holes, but not really.
Yeah, that's, like, a pretty big thing to change.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Kanga looked bad even yesterday. I think that's just Navi's core being really good.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, Mike was not a non-factor.
Yeah, he still did things. He was still healing. He was doing damage. He was throwing out stuns. He was altering.
Yeah, he was using his abilities.
Stuff.
He was healing.
He had an impact on the game. It's just there's going to be mistakes, right? And those mistakes get punished by pro players, right?
Exactly. Even though I don't know how hard he was being microed.
Oh, Fenris is actually pretty good at that, so he's probably getting microed a little bit. Mm-hmm. And the last set, 4-2 NIP versus Kanga, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I didn't get to see that whole set because I was traveling home.
Yeah.
It was a pretty decent set. The first two games were stompy for NIP.
Yeah, I saw those.
It was pretty stompy. Then it went to Frozen Guard, which I feel like is always going to be a 3-3, right?
Mm-hmm.
3-3, maybe.
I found that really weird that Kanga picked that map.
Yeah.
Because don't NIP like that map? Like, that's like a
NIP
high pick
do
for
like that map. I think they picked it a few times. I know they beat us on that map, I think, a few times by now.
I don't have my notebook to check. Well, actually, I mean, I could pull it up in my spreadsheet, but I'll just do it. Actually, no, never mind.
But yeah, I think part of the reason why they went for Frozen is they wanted a... So what they did was they banned out the Ashes first pick. So NIP isn't going to have an aggro off tank.
Yeah.
So I think they ended up going with... Was it Nando? I think NIP might have went Nando in that situation.
I don't recall. Again, I missed out.
Yeah.
I missed
the set, so...
But basically, Kanga had a free con on Frozen. Mm-hmm. You know the game's gonna last a while, so you can get your like mental fortitude and like your just mentality back in the set, right? You have some time playing and you get used to things. And they're able to win on the 3-3.
Yeah, that definitely helped them to win. They needed a map. If they lost that map, I think it would have just been a 4-0. I think their mental would have just been gone.
Yeah.
Like, so it's a good thing they picked it. I guess they were comfortable enough on it, but I feel like Nip has picked that map multiple times. I just retallied all their map picks. I forgot my notebook, so I don't have it with me, but I keep tallies of like every map pick and ban the teams do.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember Frozen Guard being pretty high on Nip's priority list. Well, we skipped over the Kanga. We skipped over the VP Navi game, but I don't think there's that much to say about it. We mentioned the Vivian,
mentioned a few things, but it was a 4-0 stomp.
It was a pretty stompy 4-0. Navi looked like old Navi. Mutu didn't look like he just woke up.
Yeah, they were playing really fucking good.
Yeah, Navi was playing really good. They needed to win 4-0 to equalize, so it's a good thing that they did.
So where are they at in the standings now?
Navi, they're above us again.
Pretty sure they're number two.
They're number two, yeah.
Yeah.
And so that's like the second seed as us?
Yeah, same amount of games.
Yes. And now second seed depends solely on who wins between us and Navi.
Oh, no, Navi's number
two. Well, I guess if we get upset by Renegades, then yeah. But like, if we win 4-0 or 4-1 versus Renegades, then our last, it's going to come down solely to who wins our set between us and Navi. And if it's a 4-3 and we still win, I think they will still go ahead of us. Maybe.
So the big thing, the big thing is, so as second seed, you're going to be probably playing against what?
Penta. Well, actually, maybe
Penta's
not.
Missing.
Penta's missing Ovin. Well, I don't know how big of a deal that is, though. They have Excentra. Is he a tank? I don't remember if he's a tank or not. We have some EU boy. Fenix is here. He'll probably know.
Yeah.
Fenix, why? You said you couldn't be here tonight. Why are you in my chat, Fenix? I asked you to be on.
What's up,
Fenix?
But yeah, so I think it's definitely going to impact their team. So I think second seed is actually huge now, since I think Penta would have been the scariest team coming out of all the teams.
Yeah,
definitely.
By good shot, because I know they've scrimmed a lot of PPL. So now second seed is very important.
Mm-hmm.
It basically gives you a lot easier first round.
Well, that's if Penta makes it. We don't know. You know. Like,
well, I mean, it could be any other team.
Well, it could be Sour.
The best team that it could have been is not there anymore, and I think it would have been a little bit scary being second seed. But now I think it's definitely the best way to go with. Third seed is now playing against Kanga, right?
Yeah, I think for sure.
Yeah, it's for sure. Kanga's not going to go against up against BP, standing-wise.
Okay.
So I think Kanga's locked in at 6, BP 5th. And it's you guys and
Well, no,
you,
we're third
Navi,
now. We're third
Andy.
Now. Yeah, yeah.
Those three teams are...
in contention still.
Yeah.
Who does Envy play? Envy plays BP, right?
Envy definitely plays us.
The last week?
I think we're
the
last
game?
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Because they're 8-5. You have 2 more games left, right?
Yeah, we have Renegades and Navi.
Yeah, they only got 1 more game left, and they have 8 wins.
Okay.
So they're behind both of you guys.
That's interesting.
Do you know who Navi's playing?
Nip
and
us.
Oh. Okay, so this...
It probably will come down to...
It will come down to it, because...
The Navi-us game.
Yeah, Envy can still get 3rd seed, right? Envy's either going to be 4th seed or 3rd seed.
If we lose to... I think if we lose both games, we can go...
You could go to 4th seed, yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So, ooh, that's interesting. So that means these next week games are going to be really important.
If Navi... It's going to depend. Next week is actually really important for seeding. Although, all the teams... I think all the teams can pretty much take games off of each other.
Mm-hmm.
It's not really a huge difference. Just like what you want to avoid the teams that you think match up better into you.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it comes down to more.
Key one would probably be NIP versus VP, right?
Yeah,
but that can't happen. I'm just using it as an example. Like VP has a really good match.
Yeah, NIP's already maybe NIP doesn't want VP to. Actually, VP can't even move at this point, right?
VP
I was gonna say
move,
yeah.
But yeah, so it's gonna be pretty big. I think third seed is huge, right? Because you're going to be playing against Kanga. I think Kanga.
Yeah, Kanga really. I think Kanga.
It's either Kanga or VP, and I think VP has a lot of strengths as a team.
Yeah.
That can be very unique, right? They're really impactful with the Janos. They really love that blast roll and having good matchups with it, with the Eevee, the Drogue.
So I'm going to get up the schedule. I switched it to the next week because we were talking about the seedings tonight. We can talk about... I guess we could do Preds while we're here.
Yeah.
This is this week still. Hold on. All right, so... Oh, it's the first game, too.
The
banger. Oh, it's our doubleheader. Oh, God.
You're doing 11 and 1?
Yeah. That sucks.
You didn't ask them to...
I should. I probably will. It'll probably get swapped. I'm going to assume we play... Let's assume we play Renegades at 3.
Okay.
We'll do it in the other order.
Mm-hmm.
So, first game, Na'Vi versus SSG.
Probably the most important.
The most important is the first one, and it's happening in 11.
Yeah.
I shouldn't predict. I'll stay out of it.
No, you need to predict. Predicting our games. You're predicting your
games.
No,
I can you guys don't have to predict your game.
No, you need to predict it. There needs to be a prediction. I'll let you go first, too.
Let me go first? No, Payne, go first. You're the guest.
Say less. I think it's going to go 3-2, but I don't...
4-3?
I mean, sorry, 4-3. Sorry.
I was like, what the fuck? No, sorry. I was like, maybe.
It's going to go 3-2. Then it's going to be a reverse sweep happening. The team is going to go 4-0 in the last two games.
I think it's going to go 4-3, but I can't pick what team. I think it's going to be really close to that, but I just can't pick a team. If I had to pick, I think it's going to go to Na'Vi. But I think it's going to be really close to that. It's going to go down to the last game.
Gonna go?
Let me go last.
I'm gonna predict 4-2 Na'Vi. I think Na'Vi has a pretty good matchup in the space station, right? Na'Vi can flex into a lot of those unique drafts that space likes to go.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they're going to be doing a lot of planning for the set.
I'm not gonna give a score, but I'm gonna give my opinion on it.
Cool.
I think it's gonna depend a lot on what version of my team shows up that day.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The team that played in that quad match week.
That's a scary team right there.
It was a very terrifying team. It was a lot about the energy that the team had. You guys can't hear it, but, like, the amount of screamed, like, Burakarai! Like
the hype was there.
Yeah. It was, the energy was there. It's going to be a lot on what kind of energy we can bring in. Na'Vi, I think, are the biggest...
The scariest team right now.
Right now, yeah. So, I'm going to do my best to prep. I think it really is going to come down to the day of the energy that comes in. I think either team can take it.
Yeah.
Historically, we have played against Na'Vi a lot. They won the last time, but we've already shown that we can turn around on teams that beat us before.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Other than Nip. But like we lost a VP and then we 4-0'd them, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. So we'll see.
Yeah. It's gonna be a really good set.
Yeah. And next game we'll do Envy versus Knights. It feels dangerous predicting this game in this house.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think you guys could take a map or two. I don't think you can beat Envy, at least right now. You guys would have to show up so hot to do it. I think Envy looks pretty good in this meta. I'll give it to them 4-1.
I'm going to predict 4-2 again for Envy, sadly. Last set was a pretty close set. I forgot what happened, like, the map order-wise, but I think we were up for the first three maps. Like, it went 1-1, then 2-1.
Yeah, we were up.
We were feeling ourselves versus Envy. We've played Envy probably the most out of every single team in PPL right now. So, like, we're heavy scrim partners. We know how each other plays. We know what the other team excels at and what they decel at, so...
I've just never heard the term decel.
This deceleration.
Do they incel at anything?
But I think it's going to be a good set. I think we're going to come out blasting for our last set of the year. Well, of the split.
Of the split, yeah.
Of the split.
The phase.
And it should be a close one.
I think we're going to win 4-1.
I like
Hell
it.
Yeah. That's the confidence you need 4-1? To actually be able to win 4-1.
Because we're going to give them that. But
yeah.
Try to keep them above us in seeding.
Yeah. Just want to give them a few map wins so they don't go too far down. We need NA to do good at this thing. So, yeah.
Right, and the last one is SSG Renegades. I'll go last again. So.
I think Space Station might have this one. I'm going to give him the solid 4-0.
4-1 Renegades. I'm calling it. I'm making the upset.
Oh, okay. Honestly, I'm gonna say 4-1 Renegades. I'm sorry, 4-1 SSC. Oh. Sorry. You. I'm gonna say 4-1 us. I'm gonna say 4-1 because we had never won 4-0 before last week. 2 weeks. So like, I think they might take a map, just because of how my team likes to play. I think they might take a map, but I think we can still take it. I'll actually be confident enough to say that. I can't wait for 4-1 Renegades to be clipped.
It's cold in here, dude.
I'm doing good. The next day, Friday, good games, dude. These are good games.
That's a banger.
Shit.
Someone say Man Pressure. So, okay. Navi Nip to start. And this will actually, if our game is like a banger, like if our game against them is really close, this Navi Nip game, like if it's really close and they win, and then we beat Renegades like 4-0, I think Navi has to win dominantly, right? To get this? To keep their second seed?
Maybe.
Right?
Probably, yeah.
Because if they only win 1 point, it feels like we gain 3. If they lose 4-0, then they lose 5.
Uh-huh.
I think maybe we'll be tied.
Right.
They would win the head-to-head, though, then. So they'd keep it, but we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see how they actually do it. Who really knows, I think, until...
It'll be easier to figure out once we get closer.
Yeah, it will.
But,
Navi Nip. I think it's going to be 4-2 Navi.
4-0 RNG every game of
4-0. I'm going to go 4-3 Navi. I feel like these two teams, they know each other pretty well, right?
Yes.
NIP has been on a downwards a little bit, you can say, but they're still looking like a really good team.
Mm-hmm.
The last I actually went 4-3 for NIP's way. And
it was 4-2 NIP's way.
It was 4-2. I think it was 4-3.
I thought it was 4-2.
I'm pretty sure it was 4-2.
I'm pretty sure it was
4-2. 4-2, really?
I can check my sheet if you want.
Yeah.
I'll check my sheet.
80% sure it's 4-2.
I guess it's 4-2. But yeah, I think Navi's going to take it, but it's going to be a very close set.
Some script results on this. Hold on.
No,
I have some spoiler-free. I have spoiler. Okay, here. This is the not-spoiler. I say spoiler like it. Navi
that
Nip.
That text is way too small for medium and C.
Navi Nip was a 4-2 because there's only six maps to pick.
Right.
Huh.
Yeah,
sure.
This is the... That's how I keep track of all the matches.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of information.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
You should see the rest of my spreadsheet, bro. It's actually kind of crazy. Oh, here's my predictions for MSI Finals. Wait, hold on.
God.
Prediction for MSI Finals right here.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
Okay.
Nip versus
okay.
Elevate.
I like it.
It's bold. Let's see.
Yeah, nonetheless, it's going to be a really good set. I don't see this going any like harder of a set than 4-2. I don't see either team going 4-1 in this. I think the two teams just know each other really well.
Yeah.
So
I think it'll be 4-2 Navi.
4-2 Navi?
I think Navi are looking pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
They are pretty solid right now. I think they are looking more on the upswing than NIP is. I'll give it to
them. Yeah.
And the final set of Phase 1. I said Phase 1. Phase 1 of PPL is VP Kanga. They're going to be the closers.
Yeah.
And that's gonna be a close set.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It went to Kanga last time. Was it 4-1? I think Kanga won pretty hard last time.
Yeah, that was the first Atlas.
That was the first Atlas.
And like VP did not look ready to play against Atlas. Like they just gave like Rhino just got Atlas, and he's like I think one of the best Atlases right now.
Mm-hmm.
I think Rhino's Atlas is like really really good.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it just tore VP apart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think VP. Now we'll take it. I think it'll be close. It might be a 4-2 VP. I think it'll be 2 4-2s or 4-3s that day.
Now the thing is, like, is it just another one of those things where like it's just how a team matches up versus another team, right?
Mm-hmm.
This could definitely be one of those things. So I'm gonna go 4-2 Kanga on this one. I think Kanga has a very good matchup, and the way that Kanga wins versus a team is going to be outplaying them as a team.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And VP kind of excels at individual performances, right?
Mm-hmm.
Especially out of Fischeko popping the F off with like an Eevee or Drogue. And as long as Kanga doesn't ego it and they just like force them into bad matchups on the blast roll, I think Kanga has a good shot winning.
Vapor, do you have an opinion on this match? Kanga VP? I have the matchup game. We can go to this so you can see.
Kanga VP?
Yeah, Kanga VP. Who do you
Kanga know? VP.
Oh. You can see the camera now. It's over. It's more like over. Yeah, it yeah, starts yeah. like here, where my phone is right now.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, he was.
Okay.
I think that should be a close one, seeing the recent results for both teams.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say 4-3 VP.
Okay.
4-3 VP.
Okay. Yeah, I think VP looked better
close.
Than I think VP looked better than Kanga.
Yeah, I do agree with that. I just think the team matchup is really good for Kanga.
Yeah.
Just like how Kanga is really good into us.
Four two VP, I think.
Think so?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Kanga looked like a lot weaker this week than I think they've been looking in general. I think they can pick it back up because I think they really have a lot of players that have been like heating up, but I think they just cooled down when they walked into skill shot, honestly. I think one of them walked into the bathroom and they froze to death.
That bathroom is cool.
That bathroom is literally like the ice locker. Like,
you know,
everybody watching the stream, other than people who've been to the Skillshot studio before,
don't understand.
You don't fucking understand. The faucets only have cold water.
Yeah.
How is that possible?
Like, I legit, there's people, I won't name names, but they will not wash their hands just because they don't want
cold
hands. And it's not cold, it is freezing cold.
Cuss.
It is bad.
He's not here. The shrinkage was real. Yeah, that's why there's really big privacy windows on the urinals. I think, like, well, you could wash your hands out in the snack room, like the chill room.
I never thought about that. Yeah,
no, those people were just being lazy and trying to get their germs all over the stuff in there. Right. And honestly, there really wasn't that much to talk about. I had to come up with my own topic this week, so that's it. So that was the damage boost thing, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Yep.
So. Here we are, Q&A, everyone's favorite part. This is actually probably a better length, I think, than last week was pretty long.
Yeah.
We'll probably do like half an hour. It was like 2 hours last week.
Bro,
an hour and a half.
I didn't realize how black you are, dude. Like,
I told you, I got tan as fuck.
Like, this is the first time I've seen
I was
you,
not
seen
lying.
Where
I
were
got
you?
Tan as fuck.
You want to tell everybody where you were?
Yeah, I went to Antigua. My aunt and uncle rented out an Airbnb there. Like a really, really nice house.
Okay.
And, there was like, yeah, dude, I told you.
Look at this. Look at this scale. Look at this.
From what?
Yeah.
Shit.
But
the only question we're getting right now is who doesn't wash their hands.
You don't want to know.
I don't think. I don't think I want to know.
Yeah, actually, you don't want to know.
Yeah. Do you think Luminary getting 20% attack speed over damage is more healthy, but still providing a niche?
Oh my god, attack speed.
Imagine Eevee.
No, that's not 20%, bro.
Yeah, no, I don't know.
How would Koga do that? It'd just be like double the start.
That's smart, Faye. That's smart, Faye. I would do that. He said, no question but life hack, because it's so cold in the bathroom in between games. Piss on your hands.
But do you wash your hands first, then piss on them? Like, how does that work?
I mean, pee's sterile, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Right?
I guess that's how you do it. Because you can't piss on your hands and wash them. It'll be cold still. That was something. But
oven.
What? Did you put on the oven?
No, it was paper.
No.
Let's see. I think the attack speed would be interesting. Teams you expect to make PML, bro, I don't know we don't know the relegation teams. Like, at all.
No.
Like, we are not the people to ask about that.
I think the only team that I know
you
about
wash your pee-pee so the piss is clean and hot. That's...
Oh,
I can see why you're
a top two team right now.
All
right,
who do I want to see relegations? Envy and El Zulu. Miss you, boys. Dude, we like Borthers. I'll turn this around. If you made a dream roster out of current PPL players, who do you pick?
I think we kind of did.
We
kind of
did talk about it. We talked. Yeah, we did actually talk about
it
last week. What was the
It was
like
Bittner, FRZ.
Yeah, it was like Tenor, FRZ, Lazy, Faye, and who was the supporting
guy? Spunky is what you guys said.
Yeah, it was like Spunky.
I think we had
Hayes,
like
right?
One cuss in there.
No, yeah.
And there's one other person I think we mentioned. So I don't remember who.
Hayes.
I don't think it's Hayes. Might have been.
Oh, Vex.
Yeah, Vex was on there. Yeah.
Tier 1 doesn't look into tier 2 scene. Relegations is tier 3.
Yeah.
Relegations is not tier 2.
Tier 2 is Borkers, Zenith.
Yeah.
The teams that are in
PML.
Bork,
Zenith, Hype, Bork, Zenith, Hype Unit, and Sanguine. Like, we know them. We know all the players on those teams.
You could also say Gorillas in the Mist.
There's no way to track tier 3, really.
Yeah.
Other
than, like, finding scrims. somehow watching scrims or, like, mentoring tier 3 teams.
Mm-hmm.
Gorillas in the Mist. I don't like that name, guys.
Really? What? I like that name.
I think, I don't
really?
Know.
That is a hilarious. There is so many memes you can do with that name.
No,
really. Gorillas in the
Mist. Gorillas in the
what?
Mist. I don't know. Just watch Grimms on Twitter. You're not wrong.
True.
You're not wrong.
Man, the console team really knows what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Who is the best support in the PPL? You can't just say your own teams. I don't know. Actually.
I think the top one that was like agreed
with
Spunky.
Spunky. Yeah, I think Spunky's really flexible with the characters he can play. I always knew Bird was good, but like recently watching him, it like surprised me how good.
Mm-hmm.
Like his mechanical ability on them were really, really solid. I think I would actually put Bird up there now too.
Mike.
Mm-hmm.
Mike was a pretty nutty fury.
Let me see. Bagel didn't take as different. Who's the blaster? Oh, you won.
Sorry.
That's a pretty good team. I could see that team relegated. It really depends on Zenith. How do you feel about potential orgs jumping into relegations? Please be careful what you guys sign.
Oh, yeah.
Please think about it. Like,
there's no benefit to it.
Listen, guys. If a team is looking to sign you for relegations, you please read the contract 100 times over. Please.
Yeah.
They're probably, most of the time, like, no offense to fucking, like, no offense to you guys, but, like, most of you are unproven going into relegations, and Paladins is a relatively small scene.
Yeah.
Please do not get manipulated and used by these organizations. You're better off on your own. Trust me.
Yeah.
Please trust me.
There's no point for an org to be with a tier 3 relegation team right now. So what's the point of signing a contract that's going to fuck you over in the long run?
Yeah. Exactly. That's how I feel about potential orcs jumping into relegations. I don't know why orcs would be jumping into relegations.
Yeah.
That's really what it comes down to. I'm going to turn on Powtech's computer.
Go ahead. Let's play some Paladins.
Let's play some Paladins. By the way, this is, if you're wondering what the mic stand is, this is actually Powtech's tower that he left here. I'm sorry, Powtech.
I might yoink it, dude, to be honest.
It's so weirdly slanted. Look at this, guys. Hold on. Look how slanted this tower is.
Yeah.
You guys, what's that shape called?
Like,
I don't know, bro. I failed school.
Like, when it's just like, is it a rhombus? Like a square? Like
trapezoid?
Like that? That's not a trapezoid.
Well,
I think it's called a rhombus.
Someone said rhombus.
Might be a rhombus.
Yeah, someone said rhombus.
I was right about rhombus. Cool.
Rhombus.
He's a rhombus-shaped PC.
Guy's in the future, dude. He's literally in the future.
And it was a rhombus. Can you get a plate of Father Cuss's food? He's
Cuss
not even here right now.
Food.
That's vapor cooking.
Yeah.
We're going to talk about Sadok Terminus. I like Sadok Terminus. Yeah, Rhombus is right. Rhombus is the tilted square. That's what I was saying.
Right.
A parallelogram? Is it a parallelogram? I don't know. We don't need to talk about that.
Wait, no. That is not a parallelogram.
I'll be right back until... You guys answer that Zin question. I'm going to go tell Vapor.
What's the Zin question?
Thoughts about Zin.
Oh. Thoughts about Zin. I mean, I thought Zin sucked before... basically Thursday, but maybe he has a place in the meta. The billow encounter, like, it feels off and it felt like the hero was dead, but NIP were making it work. I know a big thing that they were doing is they would usually have a Torvald with it, right? That's when they were picking it. I think that was Frog and Ice.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's when they did it with the Zen.
Shattered, really good.
When they did it on Shattered? Really?
Yeah. Well, that's where Nipper's playing him. They played him on Shattered.
Yeah, and they played, was it Zen with the Torv though?
No, it was just like Heidi's in.
But yeah, like, the hero still has, I guess, some, like, say in the meta, but, like, it's still, like, a really rough hero. You have to play it exactly right. If you waste one cooldown, you're dead. Or you have to wait out of the fight for 8 seconds.
Uh-huh.
So I still think he's pretty bad relatively to the other flankers right now, like Maeve and Eevee, but Nip made him work.
Do we think Hype Unit losing to Penta changes without Ovim? I don't know. It depends on what role Accenture plays. I don't think anyone really said.
I mean, I think the fact that they just went with their 6 player is a good sign, right?
Yeah. We don't know how often he scrimmed, though.
Yeah, and that they didn't just go out with a whole nother person.
He's probably viewed a lot of scrims, so...
He knows how the team plays,
operates.
How they communicate.
Mm-hmm. Accenture's a tank? Okay.
Mm.
We'll have to see.
Yeah. Is he going to be Ovim level? Probably not, but might be good enough.
Yeah, it's possible. I mean, like,
they still got some time, right? Like,
yeah, they have a couple weeks here.
Yeah, they have a couple weeks.
Ovim is very good, though.
Mm.
Ovim, like, recently has been playing very, very good. So we'll see. I think they'll be worse. Will it be enough for them to beat Hype Unit? Hype Unit is also playing with a sub, so I think it kind of becomes like a moot point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it does.
Like Hype's playing with Will.
Yeah.
Instead of Jay.
Yeah.
Couple. Oh yeah, that's right. They're not even scrimming because the EU servers are a disaster.
Are they still really
fuck.
Bad?
They're still awful. That's right. Oh god. Oh, Hype Unit might actually be able to do it.
Yeah.
No lie. I mean, like,
that's
because I don't know if their warm up game will be like. It's a console team, right? Like, they'll have some scrims when they're here. Do they play... Which console team do they play? That's the question. Which console team will...
That is a big...
Will Hype Unit play?
I think the only big ones... We talked about this. Was it only Elevate that was, like, the scary console team, or was there
another
one?
No, there's
few,
others.
There's
a few?
Yeah, because they're scrimming on PC.
Yep.
Two games every 2 hours, yeah. Basically.
Yeah, it's not good.
You play Cyclone.
Cyclone's pretty good.
Flash Boys also here. Yeah, yeah, I know this one. Cyclone. I don't remember who's on Cyclone. Oh, I have some console boys in chat. Can you let me know?
Yeah, we need the console.
Cyclone is not good. One of the console guys says Cyclone is not good.
Oh, no, that's Flashpoint. That's really good on EU. That's like,
yeah. But I think the NA Cyclone ain't it. I think the EU PML plays NA console. Right?
First or second seed.
I think for...
It's probably...
Well, no, there's no seeding on console.
Oh.
It's top PS4, top Xbox.
Oh. I don't know how they're going to do that.
Penta boot camping in EU soon? Well, yeah, okay, that's good. Well, it's still in EU. They still can't fucking scrim.
Yeah,
that means
yeah.
Nothing.
There's going to be house chilling with each other, dude. Like,
all coach roundtable? What is all coach roundtable or all coaches versus all star PPL? What does that mean? Like, what is the question there?
I think he's...
All coach versus...
Like...
Coaches versus the top PPL team, I don't know.
Coaches would lose. Surprise.
Yeah.
Unless we get Mike.
Mike might be able to 1v5.
Yep.
PML EU1 versus PS4 NA1. Is PS4 NA Cyclone? I'm sure they're right. Would you guys rather fight one Dethroner sized G Bunny or two G Bunny sized Dethroners? It would be two G Bunny sized Dethroners, right? Because you talked about how he's like a teddy bear.
Yeah, right? But wouldn't it be the opposite? It'd be two Dethroners G Bunny size. Is that, I think, what he means?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you said Dethroner's like a teddy bear, so would you rather fight the two G-Bunny-sized Dethroners?
Yes.
Instead of the Dethroner-sized G-Bunny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Dethroner-sized G-Bunny, that's a scary person, dude.
Should I pick Nord? There's a lot of questions, bro. Hold on. With the downfall of Zenith,
the question.
How much would you attribute that to the loss of Powerhouse? But who did Zenith lose?
What's up?
Who did Zenith lose? They started with, like, Neo, right? They had Neo really early. They were a revolving door. I mean, it's not,
yeah,
like...
Yeah, there
it's
was,
not about,
like... 20
yeah.
different people.
It's not about losing Powerhouse players. It's about losing everybody. Like, Zenith was a different team from start to end. But was, yeah, yeah. Zenith lost the entire roster that is now Sanguine, who was first seed, right? What happened to VP today? They lost.
Pretty badly.
Specifically, though?
It was more Na'Vi. Na'Vi had a lot to study, and Na'Vi had lost so fast yesterday they had a lot of time to study it. So Na'Vi basically, they watched that whole set. I'm sure they had a whole game plan coming in, and it completely.
And I think VP was just a little bit off today.
Yeah, I think so too.
It was a little bit of both.
Their games were close-ish, but still.
Yeah, it was still pretty big in Na'Vi's favor.
The only player to lose to every PML team, so maybe. That's interesting.
That's tough.
That game was so fast. Yeah, it was pretty quick. Dude, that the first game was so long though, bro. I literally, when I was on the desk, I was like, like I was like so dead after casting for 4 hours. It actually is so draining casting for that long. Especially when two of the games are ice mines.
Yeah.
Dude, when we got back in, the production was like, it, as soon as we put our headsets back on for the next map, I think it was Blake in production was like, oh fuck, what was it? He's like, hey, Randy, just letting you know there was a problem. They're playing Ice Mines again. Like,
it's been like, ooh, well, shit.
Death says, Bunny, did your bum ass call me soft? I'm streaming, bitch. Next time I hear an insult, I'm flaming.
Let's go.
Oh, thank you, Alex. Hopefully I can do it. I'm going to be back with them. I don't know if it's desk or cast next Friday. How much do you curl? Biceps looking thick. Gwyn.
What kind of curl? That's the thing. You know, hammer curls, I could probably do 35s on hammer curls, but... Ooh. I actually can't lift that much.
Can you pick up me right now?
Yeah. Probably. I mean, I could pick you up.
Like,
yeah.
Like, if I'm laying down, like, bicep pick me up.
Ooh. How much do you weigh?
Like, 190. 185.
Try it.
Yeah, no.
No,
yeah,
no way.
Yeah, no.
Curl me.
If I could curl 190, dude, I'd have some big-ass fucking biceps, dude.
In the green room, dude, they were talking about, like, some dude with, like, 24-inch biceps that probably works at the White House or something. Yeah, I don't remember the I walked in during the conversation, so I was like, what the hell is going on? It's Custom here. Arm wrestle Pain versus Bunny on Powtech's computer.
I'd win.
On Pals.
On Pow's PC.
I would win, dude. I'm selling it.
I don't want that one, bud.
Want to go right now?
I would dunk you, bud.
No, you wouldn't. Just go right now.
You guys want to go right now?
Right now?
Right now?
I don't have to move the mic, dude.
No, do it over. I think you should do it on the table. I'll move the computer. Move the webcam. I'll move the webcam. Actually, I'll probably move the computer, too, if you're going to be...
Maybe move the computer.
We'll turn this. We'll bring this over here. They're gonna arm wrestle. Side. They're going to arm wrestle.
Arm wrestle.
All right, we'll see this going on Pow's PC. Princess.
I thought we were
going
on the table.
You guys realize if one of you guys fuck up your arm... I'm cutting you, right? I'm being serious. I will cut you.
Don't worry, cuss, my buyout's not too high.
Crescent glass, or we can do that. I heard your Bomb King was pretty good.
Yes, it's okay. Pain is so nervous. Oh, wait, Watkins wants you to talk about the icebox, cuss.
Icebox?
Yeah.
The old practice room?
Yeah.
What's there to talk about?
We were just talking about it.
We're talking about the bathroom at the studio, how fucking cold it is.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the old practice room.
Well, he just said the ice box. It might be. All right.
We used to call the old practice room the ice box because it was always cold.
Ugh.
I guess the bathroom is the new ice box.
Yeah.
All right. Is this a good angle? What's the best angle for this? Like this?
I guess.
All right.
Should we do like this way?
Who has an advantage?
Well, then you might have to move it, then.
The table's too long.
Move the table. Yeah, that's fine. I can't even see the chat. Hold on. Give me my phone.
Oh.
Shoot, bro.
Damn, this is real pounds. Pausing games now scary after VP nip. You're not wrong. It is kind of scary. Pain versus
$70 on Bunny.
$70 on Bunny. All right. Am I gonna ref it? Like 3, 2, 1, go.
Yeah, sure.
All right, ready? All right. 3, 2, 1, go. Holy shit!
You ready?
No.
You ready?
You ready? You ready? Woo! All right, Bunny takes it. I'm not too shocked. All right, how are we gonna? You want us to like sit down around the PC now, so we don't have to move it again?
Yeah.
Guys, Bunny's the second strongest in the house.
Okay.
Oh, we gotta switch.
Oh, no, that's fine. I'm Kresnik.
This is chaos. This is chaos mode. We don't. Everything's collapsing. We're just here to chill. Let's see. Bunny is a fucking goth. Signing Pain to Elevate. Let's see if we pick it up. Let's see. Oh yeah, Vayne's free. His blaster's nuts.
Oh yeah, the Willow one trick.
This is we've gone freeform.
Yeah,
freeform.
We're just on the floor now. This is just how things are now, cuss. Who want to kiss Fanex? I'm on my way, buddy. Trinsic will low key destroy you. Are we gonna have like, dude? There was actually like a TF2 after a TF2 land. There was a huge arm wrestling like, everyone arm wrestling each other. Yeah, they even got like the two dudes like the twig arms to do it, and it went on for like 10 minutes. Like the video was like edited. They were just like,
that's fucking hilarious.
What is a blaster? The one that finger blasts the team. Yes.
Oh, no,
spot on.
Yeah,
exactly.
How big is Trent? I don't know how big Trent is.
How big is Trensic?
Trensic
can 1v5 arm wrestle all of knights.
Yeah, probably.
Trensic's big small, dude. What are you talking about?
Alright, let's see. Remember, guys, it's Q&A, so we're going to answer questions.
Any
and we're going to arm wrestle
question.
Each other.
Almost any question. Meme lord.
You can 1v5 them, but most savage. Who is the most savage meme lord in PPL?
I actually.
Who fucks around the most?
I would have said the Turner preseason, but
he's been chill.
He's been chilling the last. Well, he drools at night still really hard. But I'm thinking, who else really memes that hard?
Viral?
No.
Viral, I guess Viral kind of calmed down too.
I think it's Death.
Is it still Death? Maybe. Well, someone here? Oh, it's Kestel. Oh, you got some Burger Fi?
Yeah, buddy.
Oh, nice. Aw,
Cuss.
What? We're not on a diet.
You need to watch what you're eating, bro?
I'm bulking, dude. It's bulking
okay,
season.
Okay, bud. Bulking season.
I'm not the one that took a week off the gym, buddy. To lay on a beach and get drunk. Come on,
though. You know.
I kept my work at it.
I did a lot of swimming, dude. I lost some calories there.
Sure. And then you get drank it all back.
Yeah.
Oh, not Dethroner. LFT Dethroner apparently is the biggest meme world. Oh, yeah. Who's the worst to share an Uber with? The worst Paladins player to share an Uber with. PPL player, I guess.
Honestly.
Wait, hold on. Can I mute and say something? I'm going to mute and say something to you guys privately. All right, that was a little toxic. We're not going to mention that.
Yikes.
Okay. I don't think it's anyone on our team.
Yeah.
I wouldn't know who. Probably just someone that just doesn't talk or, like, I don't know.
What, read your lips? I was looking the other way.
Looking
yeah,
at the camera.
Yeah, you ain't going to know.
Well, I don't know. Like, who? I was looking this way, right?
Yeah, you look at us. Yeah.
Yeah.
Bobby Diem. Oh my god, everyone. Everyone's fucking.
Hey, PayPal me $5 and I'll DM you what he said.
Oh, oh god, no, no, don't do that. Don't do that.
Someone actually says.
Send me my DMs right now.
No! Slide out of his DMs. PayPal fame.
Oh
no, but like, who would the worst be? I mean, like, well, like, someone, I don't know, like, cause what's the problem? Like, someone who, like, ruins an Uber? I don't think anybody in the PPL is, like, gonna do that.
I don't
that.
Just take Ubers with teams. Like,
yeah, we don't.
We just drive back home in his car.
Quietest person PPL? Motu.
Motu.
I think that's a given.
Yeah.
Like for some other people, it's probably, like, Rochelle, right? But Rochelle is, like, really vocal in Portuguese. It's just all he says in English is, like, it's fine.
Yeah.
Like, quietest NA PPL player.
And quietest NA PPL? I think it has to be. I don't think it's anyone on our team. Player or coach? If we're talking coach, Vapor might be one of the quietest, right?
Maybe, I guess.
Coach and
who's the quietest PPL player from NA?
Quietest PPL player from NA.
Is it Dell?
No.
No?
In vocal?
The coach is counting.
Oh, it could be in vocal, yeah.
No, it's not.
You don't think it's in vocal?
No.
I've heard him drool while we played.
Well, yes, he drools.
He's not when he's focusing though, right?
Quiet, just like,
well, in vocals, quiet out of game.
Are we talking about like just communication in games in general, or just like,
just communication, like talking as a person? I think personality-wise, quietest person.
Vapor, if coaches.
Yeah,
count.
I think if coaches.
If coaches count, then okay. If a player, how much does Rock talk?
Oh yeah, Rock could be it.
I mean,
if you're like really
good feeling himself. And he's like comfortable.
What's a lot of? Oh, Tolk. Someone says Tolki.
No, Tolki.
Mighty Hud. You wish. There's no way. Still ignored? What'd you say, Faye? Let me see.
Faye was probably fucking drooling. Let's be real.
Let's see. I'm scrolling way up. Faye, I keep saying ignored. Bro, I gotta scroll so far.
He
says, when will I finally sleep? Haven't slept in 7 days. Just short naps and coffee. Napping is sleeping, bro. You right. slept.
Fanex is drooling.
You
Banning.
Slept.
Banned.
Least toxic PPL, most toxic PPL player.
Least toxic? Just hella, like, non-toxic
people. It's just everyone's not toxic, I feel like.
Who the fuck used the ketchup?
That was Payan.
You drink it?
Yeah.
Yes, he drinks it.
I drank it.
Jesus, dude. You're buying it next time.
I bought it this
time. You bought
time.
It this time.
I bought it this time. That was my ketchup.
Most toxic.
Yeah, that was toxic.
Yeah, might be.
Well, I think that answers their question for the other half of it. Or it could be Bonker for most toxic.
Bonker's hilarious.
But he's funny, but, like, I mean, literally before we were, like... But, like, I mentioned the story on cast, I think, but, like, before dinner one night, he was, like, literally in the Staybridge, I'm getting hotel food, and he's like, are you ready to get destroyed tomorrow? And I was like, yes, I'd like to eat my food, please. At that point, I had not spoken to him once, by the way. That was like the first thing he said
first
to me.
First thing he ever said.
I'm pretty sure it was like the first thing he said to me. Who says GG after every game? Like that kind of. Faye, we answered you. How is that sleep? Because you're sleeping. Player most likely to get fined. Dethroner. It's Dethroner, right? It's
Dethroner, dude.
What?
Sliding into those DMs. Those DMs get leaked. Maybe paying.
What?
Yeah, I could imagine that.
I'm gonna get fined.
No one on my team would get fined. I think. Like my team wouldn't be fined.
Aries.
No, I'm just kidding. Aries would.
Pacheco, that toxic little fucker.
Oh, Pacheco.
Fish. Yeah, fish.
Pacheco's the most toxic.
Fish
player
is the most toxic.
Sleep,
yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, it could be fish.
Death in his hunts. Highest alcohol.
Oh, I'm up there.
It's on this team.
I'm up there.
It's on this team. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I mean, Europeans are rough, dude. Europeans might have me beat, dude.
I haven't drank with anybody.
Really?
Yeah, like at all. It's Bunny 100%, says Vapor.
I mean, I'm definitely beating everyone in NA. I know that. Ew.
What do you think? Have an opinion?
Cuss is saying himself, because Cuss is,
What was my nickname in high school, Bunny? I told you.
Rank the tank. until one night. Me and Cuss for NA. Hero, I'll dunk you in 2 seconds, shrinking wise. Hero, you go red with one shot. Not even a full shot. You'll be glowing red, bud, okay?
Anima, I've learned plenty. Trust me. Yeah, Faye might know for, like, EU drinkers. Which PML players are most likely to go to the PPL once free agency starts? I mean, that depends on, like, who... That's kind of, like, opening the question of who do we think is the most likely to get cut in the PPL.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's all based on the role, right? There's certain players for each role that, like, would be moved out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's hard to say. Because, like, we don't know the inner workings of the other teams.
MomoCon, oh my god.
Like, for all we know, maybe there's, like, some internal struggle on Envy with, like, Mr. Hayes, and there's a support spot open. Like, we don't know.
We just don't know. You don't know, like, what that, or can do, like, moving player-wise, right?
Yeah.
There's so many different factors.
Yeah.
You can't, like, predict it.
Let me rephrase that. If a spot opens up in each respective
role... Okay, we'll see about that, Phoenix. We'll see.
If a spot...
I have leveled up... Tenfold.
You guys going to the bridge?
What?
The bridge?
The bridge.
Is that where you guys are doing the challenge?
All
right. So wait, what would the most likely PML player in each role you think to get picked up would be?
I think we do.
We didn't do this actually. We didn't.
We're just picking one player for each.
One player from each role.
To be bringed up, right?
Yeah, it'd be from NA. I'm assuming because like we don't know PML really that well. EU PML, excuse me.
Oh, I was not it. Okay.
I mean,
We know a little bit of you and NA.
I know a little bit.
Yeah.
Like,
I was going to say.
Like, Ovum for main.
Ovum, yeah, maybe Ovum for main tank.
I was going to say K-Country for off.
Ovum.
Over Tay, you think?
I think
yeah.
It would go okay.
Yeah, I guess Crunchy's like a main caller, right? So.
Yeah. Ovum, Crunchy. Then we'll go Blaster.
Ninu?
Sims.
Ninu or Sims.
Ninu over Sims, I think, right?
Mechanically,
like,
it'd be
Ninu was a monster
Ninu.
That LAN for
yeah,
VP,
yeah.
Bro. He was absolutely monstrous.
Yeah.
For NA, I don't know. Oh, we'll go to Direct. Who are the Directs in EU?
Directs in EU.
Yeah. It's like.
The one on Penta is like E. I don't know.
Erase.
Erase?
I think Erase is actually pretty good, yeah.
Erase is pretty good.
I'd say Edgeover.
Do you think Edge over Raze? Or,
yeah.
or also over Stigma? I think I just probably...
I think Edge over Stig, so
yeah.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. I agree.
It was close for like a month or two, but then I think Edge took it back.
Mm-hmm.
And I think for Blaster, I don't think you go Poisoner, Neo over, you know, or Sim.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I agree with that too.
I do too.
I think EU Blasters in general just tend to be better.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They feel more comfortable.
Or Portuguese Blasters.
Portuguese
I guess,
Blasters.
I don't know any other... Portuguese Blasters off the top of my head other than Freeze, so...
Yeah.
Well, Brazilian. I say Portuguese. It's not Portuguese. It's Brazilian.
Yeah.
Support?
I mean, I'm still going with what I said last week. I'm going with T-Mac on that bad boy.
You don't think Baller Steve?
I think it's T-Mac over Baller.
I think Baller Steve is really good.
Baller's definitely good, but...
Yeah. Actually, I changed... Bones.
Bones.
Bro, Bones.
You know Bones.
We talked about this before.
We did talk about this before. I get the same feeling of having Bones on my team that I do when I get like a PPL support on my team. I'm just like, bro, Bones is on my team. I'm good.
The casual
I'm good.
Bugger, dude.
I haven't seen your Drogos. I've seen your Eevee.
Who's talking?
Aries.
See your Eevee in a
I saw the
playtest
Eevee yesterday, actually.
Wait, 1v1 Alex, Worm Jets.
Oh. You play with Bones, right?
I play with who?
Bones.
The casual.
Silly bee. It's like a fancy bee.
Oh, yeah.
He's like nuts, so. Right?
I don't know on the top of my head. I don't recall gameplay or his gameplay.
Blaster is the one who finger blasts the team. Yeah, FRZ has long, long fingers. Bones is really good. Yeah, I agree.
He's
legal. It's fine. No respect on Purdo's name. I don't know. I really think I think the NIDDs might go first.
Yeah.
I saw Purdo's play at the last LAN, and I don't think it was a huge standout. Mm. I know Purdo's a good player, and he's been around forever. But I really don't remember
think
Purdo standing out to me.
Pretty good. I think Stigma's pretty good. Stigma has a lot of potential. I feel like he's got that P word. You know, I feel like he's molded the right way. He can do a lot.
If Watkins, Envy, El Zulu, and other players from PGS came back from Heal Barley, I mean, I would love to... Dude, Envy is, like, one of the chillest dudes to hang out with ever. He's actually so funny, and nobody knows it. Like, yeah. I would love to see... I would love to hang out with Envy again, bro. He's, like, so good at Jackbox games. And others. I don't know... I mean, I don't know who else the others would be. We know Ninja Lizard. What about Amosts? My experience with Amosts is not very high.
Not really that good.
Stigma's like a Ricotta, but different. What does that mean? Who's the best at Smash? Who is the best? You know who's the best at Smash? The guy in Skillshot who has accepting challengers Smash
yeah.
Bros. On his desk.
I see that all the time, and I always just want to sit down in that chair like, let's go, bud.
Yeah. I don't know whose desk that is. Is it Matt's? The video editor? I think
it's
the editor.
Yeah,
Matt,
it's the
right?
editor.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Have, like,
he is the best at Smash.
With, like, videos that
he
needs to
he
do.
Literally has, like, literally when you walk to the bathroom, there's a sign that says, accepting challengers. Play me in Smash.
And you'll
it's
always,
Matt, right? Yeah, yeah.
You'll always see someone at that chair randomly. Throughout the day, you'll just
yeah, and I have a feeling Matt is absolutely giving him the business all day.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't be shocked. Mayor best at Smash? Maybe. Shash is the best at Shash. Let's see, any other names? Questions. Scrolling up. We missed some, I think, while we were talking. Oh, God. Who watched E3 this week? Everybody
no.
did. Everyone excited? Let's top E3 excitement game.
I honestly didn't look at E3.
You didn't even hear any excitements? Any announcements?
I've been kind of in the dark last
time.
Favorite
like
announcement?
Cyberpunk?
Cyberpunk?
Yeah, probably that one.
Tales of Arise. Hell yeah. Mm. Let's go. I'm scrolling up to see if I missed anything while we were talking. Top 5 drunk mom. That's...
Which PPL team could be the best in CSGO? Who has the best aimers, basically? And I think that might be in it. Overall, best aimers.
Listen, have you seen how far Rashao tilts his keyboard? He must have come from CSGO. His is, like, vertical.
Yeah.
Who came from CS? Well, no, because it's like, you need CS experience, too. Like, you can't just, like, if you're good
straight
at aiming, like, you
to
need to know spray
even
patterns.
If you're good at aiming, there's still a lot of mechanics you need to know.
Yeah. So
but
like,
I think general wise, I
feel like Nip seemed like the type of group that would come from CS. I don't know why. I just feel like those bunch
Nip,
of people.
I mean, like, I think my whole team played CSGO at some point.
I mean, I think
a little
most,
bit.
I think I did. Did you?
Did you
I
play it seriously? Kind of, like, was it like your main
yeah,
game?
Yeah,
okay.
I did it for a little bit.
I didn't.
Does anybody know? Because I know Rock, like from Envy, Rock came from TF2.
Yeah.
What did Envy? What did everyone on Envy come from? What did
Ruba come from? Like Overwatch.
Ruba came from
Overwatch.
Haze was. Random was. Didn't Random come from CS?
I don't know.
This would actually be an interesting. I actually don't know a lot of this.
Yeah.
I think Ares. Did everybody on our team come from CS?
No, FRZ came from TF2.
FRZ plays CS though too.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. Like I saw him play it a little bit. Like he was aiming in it. He was doing like DM, so like he knows at least somewhat what to do. Should Renegades make roster changes? I mean, that's their decision to make.
Yeah, we ain't their coaches.
Yeah, like do they think there's enough potential there?
Do they think there's enough potential?
None came from CS. Really? Where'd you guys all come from? I don't even know, bro. We haven't even talked about this. play some ranks together. Oh, that's what it is. Okay. You guys have played CS, but none of you had CS as your main game. Okay.
I think a few people came from League. I know Cuss was League, Overwatch. Ricotta did a lot of League. I did a lot of League.
Y'all did a lot of gaming, bro.
Yeah. I didn't fuck them, dude. I visited everywhere, dude.
I played like 3 games.
Bro, I'm all hero shooters. I'm literally TF2, Overwatch,
yeah.
Paladins. Like, I've only done hero shooters.
Vayne came from League. Minecraft PvP.
That's me, bro. Facts.
Mito plays more CS than Paladins. He hasn't launched more because he's trading all the fucking time. Literally every time between scrims, he's either playing Binding of Isaac or trading in CS. Like,
wait, what?
Constantly. He,
that's
he,
fucking
all.
You said trading?
No.
I thought you said training.
No.
That's fucking hilarious.
Envy, random top fragged in the Envy versus G2 CS pug game.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Oh, shit.
Would I make changes in Renegades? I don't know their team dynamic, man.
Yeah, you
I haven't listened to their comms. Like, I don't know. If I was to make changes, it would be if someone was being a problem in communication.
Mm-hmm. There's so many different dynamics in Paladins, mm-hmm. and so many different things that will make your team better and make your team worse.
Yeah.
You won't know until you've watched over the team or played with the team for a few weeks.
Yeah.
Bro, we should first Envy and CS.
Yeah, we'd fucking dumpster them, dude.
Hell yeah, we would.
Dumpster Envy.
Play Battalion.
Battalion. Mm. We would dumpster in Battalion.
Best cook in PPL.
Shit, that's probably
me. I would take Cuss.
That's probably
not
mean.
Payne at all.
Why not?
You don't cook Payne.
I could.
When was the last time you cooked something in this house?
Like 2 days ago.
What was that?
Chicken and waffles.
No, you didn't.
Macaroni and cheese. Kraft. Velveeta. Velveeta, baby.
Ramen or microwave pizza.
Oven.
Mito cooks pretty well.
I think it'd be Cuss, dude. Cuss got that experience, you know?
Mitao makes, like, pasta with tuna and, like, paprika and stuff. It's really good, actually. Did you guys have a bidet yet? They just sit on a super soaker instead.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Don't go in that bathroom. Oh, we got hosted by somebody, I think. We're at 81 viewers.
Pog.
Cuss has lived an entire life before his pro career. I looked up to make sure it was not down the stairs when I read that.
Best housewife in PPL.
What?
I don't know. It's not me.
Vapor does a lot for us, dude.
Vapor was cleaning the house today.
Yeah, Vapor went hard today. He vacuumed. He did all the dishes. I did the counters. He took out some garbage.
Messiest player.
I think the messiest on our team is Payne.
No. It is not true.
Okay, then who is it then?
Yeah,
it's not me. It's not Cuss.
Have you seen his desk, bro? It's way messier than mine.
Mm.
Cuss's desk is way messier than mine. And that's a fact. You know that too. That's why
I'm thinking it's you, bud.
Have you seen his desk?
Yeah, I've seen his desk.
Who's the most polite player? I don't know.
You forgot to read the rest, and why is it me?
Why is it you?
Who said that?
Fucking Phoenix.
I fucking knew it.
Because you can't be mean on 30 minutes of sleep. It's impossible. Let's see. Third question. Which players can make Mutu left real hard? That's a Phoenix question. I've barely spoken to Mutu.
I feel like my team could rule out him pretty hard and make him laugh.
I feel like all we know of Mutu, you guys would think that making Mutu laugh is like making one of the guards in front of like the Royal Palace in Britain laugh.
I must focus on fragging.
Yeah.
Fragging only.
Like Mutu wearing one of those big, big furry black hats, like no one would be surprised. From NA. Like, I'm sure there's a different view of him in EU, but most of the people from NA don't really know him that well.
Yeah.
Which players can make Mutu real hard?
What was the question?
Phoenix just read it wrong.
Don't worry about it, buddy.
Vayne Eagles. Oh, that's so true. Vayne and Aspect are the messiest outside of PPL. Outside of PPL,
I've seen the pictures.
So
we've all
bad.
Seen the pictures.
What the fuck is up with that? Oh, my God.
Did I not get DM'd on Discord after I muted myself? I'm curious. I did. I certainly did.
How many?
It was like 5.
Jesus.
Well, it's because he did the...
The mute mic thing.
Yeah.
I think I got paid like $12 right now already.
You just got random money?
No.
What the fuck?
I'm kidding.
All right, I think we'll take like two more, and then we'll kill it. This has been a long one. Let's see. Whoever wants to get in here, we'll take the I'll take the first two unless it's like a clearly troll question.
Questions.
When should I? Okay, that's a troll question. But never. You are the heart and soul of this community. We all love you, Phanax. Where do you want an international LAN to be hosted? Ooh.
Somewhere in EU, please.
I mean,
yeah, EU.
Yeah, get the fuck out of the United States. Go to EU. Yes. Whether it be like somewhere in Spain or like
Sweden.
Sweden.
Mm-hmm. EU or Korea.
The Netherlands. Why would we do Korea, dude?
Brazil.
There's not even servers in Korea.
Yes, there are.
Dude, I would get love from if we went to Brazil. Let's go.
Let's go.
I'd feel scared.
Get some.
I feel scared.
Why would you
go to Rio Grande?
Why would you be scared, G Bunny?
Dude, it's a new country, man.
That's a town of my people, bro. You saying you'd be scared?
We will guide you, my friend.
Yes, will guide
we
me.
Will guide you.
Ares needs to protect me, dude. Bodyguard Ares.
Better pay him, bro.
And Europe isn't a new country, because Europe's not a country.
Facts.
He said somewhere in Europe will guide me through. Dude, I'll get like the Brazilian. I'll get like the Brazilian guided tour.
Yeah.
Everyone will love me there. The most authentic. Oh man, dude. Oh my god. I had some amazing pão de queijo at this Brazilian bakery. At this Brazilian steakhouse. After we won, we went to that. It was so. Oh my god, dude. It was so fucking good. It was almost like a cheesy biscuit that's like warm.
Okay, I could go for
so
that.
So good, so good. It is crazy. Who would we give MVP to for this regular season split?
Say that again?
For me, I would do Tanner.
Yeah,
I think Tanner has been the person that looked the best in his role by a good margin, right?
Yeah.
Has any other DD looked as good as Tanner this season?
No.
And I don't think anyone's. I think people are kind of close to certain points of the season, but throughout the season, like he was.
Tanner's been the most
consistent.
Yeah.
And he's done it on like multiple characters too, right?
Multiple
he plays
characters.
Pip.
He had like the most flexibility. He brought out most of the stuff. He was popping off on the money and like 1v5ing with that shit, dude. Tanner.
Diggy,
was nuts.
Diggy also. It's got to be someone on Nip, right? Which is
yeah,
the
yeah,
performance.
It has to be
someone
on it.
And I think it's.
I think it would be Tanner, but I think Diggy would be a close contender because he's like he switched roles and became one of the best in his role quickly.
Yeah, I
agree. Alex showed flexibility, but I don't think he's had insane performances like.
He wasn't as consistent as Tanner.
No, yeah, agreed.
I feel like.
Agreed. I think it's Tanner still.
And like even in that role, like he's on another role, right? This season has been a lot on like the blaster popping off, and like it's been more of a consistent thing. I think.
Yeah.
So like with Tanner popping off from the DD role, like that's. That's something special right there.
All right. Tenor means teeth? Bird? Maybe. All right. We'll take one more question because those questions are really good, and I think we can do one more.
Yeah.
So, who has the worst gamer tag?
G-Bunny1.
It might be
G-Bunny1.
G-Bunny1.
I think if I think, let's see, other contenders. I think if Tenor's name was just Tenor, it'd be a lot better. I think it being the whole is Bittner. Is a little like
yeah.
I don't know if it has meaning or something. I think Tenor's name is just Tenor would be
a lot better.
Better.
Mm-hmm.
Mike has the best. I don't know what you're talking about.
Dude, I feel like it should have been just Mike, no one, just a uppercase
M.
One.
Let's see. Wait, who? Okay, so go through all the players.
Oh,
right,
Renegades.
Right? Renegades. So Moonchopper, Hero, and Vocal.
Moonchopper's Hero's fine.
Yeah.
Vocal.
It's fine.
Good. Fine.
Shadow's good.
Shadow's good. Viral's good.
Viral's good.
Yeah.
Okay. Then we'll
it
go
means
us.
Ice Teeth? Okay. So his name actually does mean something. Okay.
All right. So.
A little better then.
Bittner.
So. Yeah. So.
All right. So Cuss.
We're working up. Yeah. So Cuss.
Cuss
QD.
Fine.
G21. I think it's a contender.
Oh.
It's a contender.
It's a contender. Yes.
Pain.
That's unique, bro.
Pain's pretty unique.
I'll give it an N.
Ricotta.
There's no way you're going to get
it.
Ricotta's is good, but like.
It sounds like Ricotta cheese.
Because you could say like multiple things. Like, I like the mispronunciation of his name where you're like RKTA because it actually flows really well. It even
yeah.
rhymes. Like,
yeah.
I think even saying it wrong, it sounds good.
Mm-hmm.
Who else is on your team again?
And
the Throner. That's right. This is good too.
Can we add Coach's Paltek?
It's going to be questionable, Dave.
Vapor.
Sorry, pal. That's fine.
Vapor, yeah.
Vapor one,
okay,
though.
Up one.
But how he spells vapor, yeah.
Right, so up one, two.
Yeah, Kanga. Also, Rhino.
Yeah. Well,
Joel's.
It makes... Joel's is fine.
Joel's is fine.
Fine name, I think.
Chronic.
Chronic's is good.
Evoli's good.
Evoli's good, yeah. Except, like, no one knows how to pronounce it. They were saying Evil Eye on the cast, and I was so used to saying Evoli. I said it, like, both ways, like, eight times.
But how Ricardo likes to say, draw.
Gera. Gera's good.
Gera.
Yeah, Gera's good.
Gera's fine, yeah.
And Coach B hates, I mean, it's fine.
Hades is
fine. It works also. The Joel's Hades combination is good as, like, a combo name.
VP? We got Vex 30.
Vex 30, good, I think. Because you could just say Vex.
Yeah,
Vex.
Yeah.
Like, yours is still, like, even though you have the number and it, like, definitely takes
everyone
the points away from you,
G-Bunny.
It's still, but it's still, like, G Bunny. I don't know.
Yeah.
Gangster Bunny.
Gangster Bunny 1.
Dose
Ups.
Polioli. Polioli's fun to say.
Yeah, that's a really fun to say, actually. Hikate, also fun to say.
Hikate is good.
Fisheko.
That's good.
Little fishy.
Yeah, that's good. Nice one, fish. Envy. Actually, Spuds. I think that's fine. It's like a cutesy angle to it. I think that's good. Envy, Metapusher. Very unique name. I've really never heard a name like it. Honestly, like it's so out there. It's good.
Name. It's a sweater name. I like.
Well, exactly.
He's a meta pusher. He's going to push those fucking limits, man.
Let's see, Rock Monkey and Random. I think that
Rock Monkey.
Those are like
random new. And
Rock Monkey. That's someone. Rock. I love you. You have definitely committed to your younger self's name. You stuck with it. Like, there's a guy in TF2 right now whose name is Michael PC1. And, like, that's definitely somebody who, like, his teacher made an account for it when he, on his, like, the school laptop.
Yeah.
And he was like, I guess that's just me. Now I'm Michael PC1. I mean, it's TF2. The kid could be eight. It's really entirely possible. He could be an 8-year-old.
Random Noob TV. Those two, I think Rock and Random Noob are up there, Bunny.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think they're out there.
I think so, too.
Yeah, they're
up here. Rubu's good.
It's good. It's creative. It's
Tolki.
Unique. The way he capitalizes it is unique, too.
Yeah. Tolki.
Tolki.
Good.
Another unique name.
Mr. Hayes.
Now SSG.
Okay. So,
Ares.
God of War.
Good.
That one's good. Freeze God. His name is just like used to be Frozen, and he added the God to it.
I like that. I like Freeze God.
Yeah.
Freeze God's good. Was it good, Cuss?
And his nick, for those of you English speakers, his nickname, what they call him most of the time, is like Fogeta, which means like, the way they explained it to me was it means like stove and rocket are kind of like the same, like they're really similar words in Portuguese. And there was a thing where when he was younger, when his family would like cook something in the house, it would like, his computer was so bad, it would like crap out his PC. So like it kind of became... Fogao. Yeah. So, like, it became like a meme. He was like the stove blaster. Like, that's like his nickname. It's like combination of like rocket and stove, like, became the thing. And that's like his nickname from.
Okay. Rachel.
Hishao. Is how they pronounce it.
Hishao.
Yes. Hishao. Because that's like their accent. Like, actually, one thing, I thought they were saying heel ash for the longest time, but it's actually just how relaxed sounds in their accents. Because it's like, halash. Like, halash,
halash.
Yeah. Recently, I realized they were saying relax, and it wasn't like a...
Heel ash.
Call it heel ash.
Yeah. Well, not like a heel ash, but like just a different word that I knew. Because I knew, because they were saying it when they didn't have an ash. So obviously, it couldn't have been heel ash, always.
Heel their ash, dude.
Mitto. Or Mitao.
Mitao. Yeah, Mitao's good
fine.
Name. I think.
Sadak.
Unique.
Good.
Yeah.
My name. I think it's
Krasnik.
Fine.
Yeah,
I like it.
Good.
I took it from a game, but then I found out it's like a Norse vampire hunter afterwards. I'm like, all right, cool. I'll stick with it. That's where they got it from. We're in the EU teams now, right? Navi.
Navi and NRP left.
Yeah, so.
Lazy. Interesting
lazy
way of how he
spelled
it.
Spelled uniquely. It's unique.
Phoenix. Good. Really. I like it.
Yeah, Phoenix is good. It's also unique.
Mewtwo.
I think all of Navi's names are good. Mewtwo, Spunky, Creatives.
Creative.
Watch it. The two at the end makes a points. We'll creatives. Take away points for the create for the two.
Yeah.
But it's not all the way down there.
Oh, what's up, Scratchy? And yeah, so then NIP. I think most of their names are fine too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, well, Mutu used to be Mutu Stina. Yeah, Bonker. It's kind of like the cutesy angle again, kind of like what Spuds has. That's fine.
Alex.
Bonker Alex. I mean,
At first, it was a little rough.
It's been, but it means cold tooth apparently in like the native language.
Bird.
It's fine. Also, yeah. And who are we forgetting from that team?
Diggy.
Yeah. And that's a good
Diggy
name. It feels good to say Diggy Dog. Yeah, exactly.
Diggy Dog.
Awesome, right?
So now going back on, it's obviously Rock Monkey Random. It can't be G Bunny.
You just don't want it to be you, bro.
Obviously can't.
I think anybody with points with numbers in the name get it taken off, other than Vex because it's such a short name. Like Vex 30, like if he just wanted to be Vex, he couldn't just be Vex.
Someone
had to have the numbers.
So someone had the name G Bunny, and it just never got it solved.
What does it say in New Jersey?
G-Bunny
1. It actually says G Bunny on some of them.
Really?
Yes.
On some of them.
On
what
some
does it say
them.
On your current jersey that you wear two PBL matches?
I do not know.
G-Bunny 1.
Probably G Bunny 1, though.
Alright. Just Vex would be cooler. I don't think you can have three digit.
You can't.
You can't. Like he had to have numbers if he wanted to be Just Vex. And so I think that's what I'm saying. No points taken off for Vex because his name is so short. That's true. All right, guys. I think that's it. We can wrap up. You guys have anyone you want to... Like, Payne, you're the guest, right? We shout out every week. Do you have anything, any people you want to shout out? Anybody?
No, I'm good.
Not even your own team?
What's up?
Shout outs to the Knights?
I was going to make a draw response, but I'm okay. Nah, I'm good. No shout outs.
Shout outs to Smile Direct. Shout outs to Smile Direct Club. Really good sponsor. We have an event coming up with them very soon. Look out for that. It's going to be a fun one around here.
Yeah.
Around here?
Yeah, it's actually around
here. Are you shivering?
Yeah,
it's freezing.
Oh, I guess I'm the only one wearing it. How are you? You're in a sweatshirt. He's in a t-shirt and shorts. You're in a sweatshirt and pajama pants.
I'm freezing.
but yeah, thanks to all the sponsors for the nights. And follow my Twitter.
Follow Payne2K too. Yeah, follow us all on Twitter if you guys haven't already. We try to do this once a week. Next week, I have two possibilities for guests. I have ideas.
Oh.
I think...
Are we doing the MSI one, or
next
are we
week,
doing predictions for that?
No, that'll be the week after, because we have a break week between.
Okay.
What I'm thinking... Hey, what's up to Molly? God damn, dude. I can't answer that right now. Oh, yes. I'll try to stream tomorrow. I can answer then. So... Here's the two options. I'll ask you guys what you think. So my two options were I would ask someone from production at Hi-Rez.
Oh.
So whether it be one of the casters.
That'd be cool.
Or that was one option. I haven't asked them yet. I'm going to ask one of the casters so we could try to have like a production side of things since we won't have too much. Randy, I don't think he's there next week.
Get Dulson.
Maybe. Dave might want to do it. Or Freeze God. And Freeze has already agreed to do it. And the reason I would want Freeze is so that the English speaking audience really doesn't know Freeze that much or talk to him really. So I think that would be a really good like way for you guys to be able to talk to Freeze
And
like find out stuff about him.
That.
Yeah.
Mike.
So my options. So I think out of those two, which would you guys rather see? I can try to get someone from production, or I can just get Freeze. If you guys say production and I can't get someone from production, then I would just get Freeze.
Right.
Could you potentially make it to Axis if you wanted to do it from Axis?
Because
the guy who does the spectating works at Axis.
Oh, sure. Really?
Yeah. So if we decide to do it with Conrad, I'll talk to him about it. Then we would probably do it from there.
Why not both? Because that's all that you want to spread it out.
Why not both? Yeah, because we can't have like a 3-hour podcast where we talk about everything. Three people is like perfect, and even then, like we still talk over Payne sometimes.
Yeah,
like three people is like the ideal.
Yeah, I think FRZ for next
Freeze
one.
Freeze then production.
Try and get production for like the MSI prediction one. That would be pretty sick. Mm-hmm. If we get like.
Well, actually, no, because we get a caster's prediction.
Yeah,
right? That works good. Yeah,
that'd
that's
be
super
pretty
fun.
Sick.
Okay, so yeah, I'll talk to... So we have Freeze next week, most likely, and I will try to get somebody... I'll try to get one of the casters in for the following week. That'd be sick. Okay, guys. I was going to keep it a surprise initially, but I figured I'd rather ask you guys and get your opinion, so... Thank you very much. Let's find someone to host. Let's bomb somebody.
Let's do it, bro.
Asketit, if you will. I have it bookmarked because I always host people.
Nice.
Who the fuck is Johnny Blaze? Mode, Battle Royale. Wait, what is that guy's hair? Most 24 hour streams. All right, he's not a normal Paladin streamer. He's not a normal Paladin streamer, so we're gonna not host him right now.
You should do something with like zero viewers.
That's more like. Oh, don't go too fast. What? Miss out.
I skipped Cyberbolt.
Okay, we might want to do the Throner. You know, my boy.
I saw the Throner. No, I follow him though.
Zero viewers. Do you know what I'm saying?
Ooh, Lion Knight streaming.
Oh, we could do Lion Knight.
We could do Lion Knight. He's pretty low. The thing is, the people down here, most of the time, they're like... I don't like hosting people with too few viewers that I don't know because I don't want to send you guys to someone random.
Farewell, top left.
Farewell? What? Up here?
Farewell.
Oh, Farewell. I was thinking Farewell. Let me go a little bit further down, see if I can find like someone we know with like zero viewers or something. Follow if you are new. There was this. Do you guys remember that one dude whose name was literally like?
I think I know.
Like keep smoking 420.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember that shit.
I've hosted the Throner several times from this, so I think I might host. Oh, Apache. One viewer, Apache.
Yeah, Apache.
Yeah, we'll host Apache.
Apache.
Fuck, this touchpad sucks. Are we gonna host Apache, guys?
What is that number?
That's the time they've been streaming.
Oh, okay.
All right, thank you guys for. Oh shit, I don't have my. I'm gonna pop up my chat.
Oh my!
It's like 2 seconds.
Kresnik.
It's like 2 seconds. All right, guys, thank you very much for hanging out. We're gonna host Apache. Go in, say hey. You can drop some of your any emote you want. Honestly, if you sub to me, then obviously you know you could drop a Krez love, Krez hey, Krez whatever you want. We will see you guys next week, probably with Freeze God most likely. And yeah, I mean that's it really. We'll see you guys then.
Deuce.
Peace out.